Sonny, have you seen anything better than that?
No, I haven't. That that definitely gives me goosebumps. Listening to Eddie Betts, someone who, you know, I also idolised growing up, and you know, to listen to that obviously gave me goosebumps, but also made me really excited about this week.
Michael Walters, it is great to have you with us. Is any sentiment there, the game makes me smile? That would resonate with you, wouldn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, growing up, it was one of those things that took me away from whatever troubles I was going through or whatever feelings I was having that weren't great. Footy was the pathway, I guess, that that made me feel good about myself and got me enjoying footy and my friends as well.
And the opportunity for us all to celebrate, in Eddie's words, not only what you do, but who you are. Does the significance of this weekend, has it embedded with you as you've gone through your league career?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the Indigenous round, you know, obviously the AFL is a massive platform to not only go out there and play footy, but also educate as well. Teach more about the Indigenous culture, about where I'm from, where Eddie's from. There's many different tribal pathways out in Australia that that people don't know about, and you know, this is the perfect platform for us to go out there and speak about ourselves, but speak about our uncles and aunties and what they had to go through to get us to where we are right now.
5 years ago, Michael, would you have been able to talk like you are at the moment? Because you were a bit of a hothead, and I think all of the football, all of us fans have watched you grow up to be this incredible thinker, and you seem really content of who you are and what you can do on a football field. Does that resonate with you?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, 5 years ago, there's no way I'd be able to speak in front of my teammates out in front and talking about structure and stuff like that. But, you know, the more and more you get out there and put yourself out on a limb, I guess, and and also really educating yourself and knowing the structures, but then also to be able to do it, in media conferences, but also on TV, live or pre-recorded. I'm one to go out there and also build a path and show the younger players that, you know, if I can do it, you can do it. There's nothing to be shy or shame about. Just go out there, speak your mind and just enjoy being in the position you're in.
Just brilliant.
Yep.
Michael, just brilliant. I've got the jumper in front of me here. I hope you can see it. Who designed this, mate?
Yeah, so Anthony Grobo designed it, a past player, 200 games at the Fremantle Footy Club. Him and his, Grobsy and his two sisters designed it. It signifies the past, the present, but also the future in, the new coach with JL. There's 20 dots there that represents JL and the future with his number 20. The kangaroos and the emus represent moving forward. Obviously the stolen generation flower there as well to represent the past and also moving forward too.
And there's one young man who's going to wear that jumper for the first time, a Fremantle jumper for the first time. That's Liam Henry, who was pick 9, and Anthony Grover was there to present it to him, we understand.
Yeah, he was, and you know, we weren't really sure how he was going to do it. He ended up telling us about the jumper and showing us boys the jumper and talking about how they designed it with him and his two sisters and also other family members. But for Liam to play his first game in Indigenous round is a massive opportunity for him to go out there and showcase his talent. But all the hard work that led up to it, he dislocated his kneecap in last year in one of the school games, and for him to come to the footy club, work on his body, he put a couple of kilos on in muscle, but also rehabilitation on that leg has been second to none. So it's just an unbelievable feeling for someone like him to come from up north and come to the city of Perth and represent his family from up there, but his culture on Indigenous ground is massive.
Hey, Michael, we know your affection for Ross Lyon and vice versa. Ross often talks about the relationship you two had. Ross has gone as coach and Justin Longmuir has come in. For those who've never seen him before, we have, but tell us about him. What is the character of the man that most endears you to him and him to his players?
Yeah, well, he's, once again, you know, ever since he got to the club, you know, he wanted the players to get the best out of themselves and really improve on their own game individually. And there's no doubt that, you know, the coaching staff as well, he encouraged them to get the best out of themselves, not only the players, but the coaches to, you know, really improve the younger players at a fast rate. And, you know, he's infectious. You know, it's easy to talk to him. You know, you can go, I feel like you can go to him with anything going through your mind. You can easily walk up to him and have a yarn to him. So he's one of those players that likes to talk to you one-on-one, likes to get to know about you and your family. And there's no doubt that a lot of players are starting to thrive off that.
We've asked all the players, we've had a couple of young blokes on before about who were their Indigenous heroes growing up. Who was your fave when you were a kid?
Yeah, when I was a kid, you know, I loved Ronnie Burns and obviously, all because I was a massive Geelong supporter, but, you know, you got guys like Eddie Betts, who I really enjoy, Andrew McLeod, obviously Mickey O and Goodsy, for what they've done to, you know, to the AFL game is massive, you know, and guys that helped them out, that paved the way before them in the Nicky Winmars, the Cracker Brothers, guys like that, it's a flow-on effect. And I'm hoping one day that I can also do that for the next generation coming through. And hopefully I can do that.
Hey, rest assured, mate, you're doing it.
Yeah,
you're doing
it. Shea Bolton already told us that growing up, you were his guy. So you're already doing it. And I'm glad
he's actually dominating at the moment.
He is.
I'm glad Ronnie Burns got it mentioned. Michael, the Goods O'Loughlin medal is part of the Marne Group trophy game. You're part of that. It would be a good medal to win. Good luck with it, and thanks for being part of our night.
No worries. Thanks for having me, guys, and I love the show. I watch yours all the time.